Let's understand bean tag in such two. Bean tag is used to instantiate a class in JSP. That is, by using bean tag, we can create an object of a particular class within JSP. Shown are the various attributes of bean tag. The first attribute is known as var, which will allow us to refer to the bean which is pushed in value stack. The second important property is name, which refers to the class whose bean is to be created in the JSP. One important point to note here is the bean which we are referring should respect specifications laid down by Java bean. The third property is ID, which is again used to reference the value pushed in value stack, but it is depreciated form of the same. Let's understand more about bean tag with an example. Name bean is the bean which is used in this example, which is present within the package com.qspawn.bean. This bean has three attributes: first name, last name, and full name. We have setters and getters for the same. Within the getter for full name attribute, we concatenate first name and last name, which gives us the full name. The JSP which we are using is index.jsp. We have included the struct2 tag library. Using this tag library, we create the bean tag referring to the name bean. Now, to initialize the attributes present within name bean, we make use of sparam, in which we specify the name of the attribute which we want to initialize. In this case, we are initializing first name and last name as Rama and Rahul respectively. Now, within the bean, if we want to get the property full name, we write as property value is equal to full name. On executing this example, we will get the value of full name as Rama Rahul, since it is concatenation of first name and last name. Shown is the second way of assessing the bean, in which we again create a bean referring to the name bean class. We have the ID set to name handler. We initialize first name and last name for this bean with Rani and Giri respectively. Now, if I want to assess the bean outside the sbean tag, we can do the same by using the ID attribute, which we set as name handler. Thus, by using the OGNL expression hash followed by the name of the ID, which in our case is name handler, we will be able to refer to the required attributes present within the bean. In this case, we are referring to full name, which will be again concatenation of first name and last name respectively. Thus, we have seen two ways of assessing the bean, one within the sbean tag and other outside the sbean tag with the help of OGNL. Now, let's deploy this application and find out the corresponding output. On deploying the application in Tomcat and on putting the following URL in the browser, I am able to see this page. In this, we get the value of first full name as Rama, Rahul. Since in the first bean, we set the first name as Rama and last name as Rahul. Similarly, by using the second bean and with the help of OGNL, we are able to get the value of second bean full name as Rani Giri, since Rani was the first name and Giri was the last name. Thus, we have successfully seen how to make use of sbean tag provided to us by struct2. Next, let's see what all data tags are provided in struct2.